Okay, 21. S1, S2 are respectively the sets of local maximum and local minimum points. What are they? Okay, fine. F of x is equal to 9x power 4 plus 12x cube minus 36x square plus 25. They are asking where it attains local maximum, where it attains local minimum. So, 19 question, very easy. What is f dash x? 9 into 4x cube plus 12 into 3x square minus 36 into 2x. Everywhere 36 is there, I can take 36x common. I'll be left with x square plus x minus 2. 36x. This one, when I factorize, I'll get x minus 1 into x plus 2. So if I take number line, you will get minus 2 and 0 and 1. Obviously, positive, negative. After one, it is positive outside, alternative plus minus. Now tell me, up to minus 2, the function is increasing. After that, it is up to minus 2 decreasing and after that increasing. At minus 2, what it is? Local minimum. At 0, the derivative sign changes from plus to minus, increases and then decreases. It must be local maximum and local minimum. Okay. So here it is minimum. Here also it is minimum. Here it is local maximum. That's it. They wanted that. S1 is local minimum, minus 2 and 1. S2 is where local maximum, which is 0. That's it. Very simple. Where derivative sign changes from plus to minus, local maximum, minus 2 plus local minimum. Don't waste time. Okay, 24. Maybe from the graph you'll have a better idea about 24. After minus 1, the function is 2x plus 3, which is a straight line. Okay. This is minus 1. At minus 1, it is 1 open interval. Okay. This is 2x plus 3. Okay. After minus 1, the function is a line 2x plus 3, a line with slope 2. At minus 1, its value is 1. Okay. And because it is open, so I wrote this open circuit. That point is not there. Everything after that is there. K minus 2x, that is before minus 1. Okay. That will be a line with the slope minus 2, so like this. But it can come here, it can come here. So depends on the k value. So k minus 2x, it will be k plus 2. Maybe the graph is like this, or maybe it is like this. I don't know. But this point should be k plus 2. So now take two different graphs. Take this separately, this separately. One is like this. One is like this. Okay, now tell me, this is at minus 1. This is also at minus 1. At minus 1, is this function attaining local minimum? No. If this is a minimum, but these values are much lower than that, right? Okay. But look at this. Even though the discount was not a problem, at minus 1, it is local minimum. In fact, it is absolute minimum, because before minus 1, all the values are greater than that. After minus 1, also all the values are greater than that. So among all the possible y values, is the lowest. Okay. If you want that at minus 1, the function should attain local minimum, this k plus 2 should lie below this, not above this. Okay. So k plus 2 should be less than or equal to 1. K less than or equal to minus 1. K can be any number, but it should be less than minus 1. Then only this function attains local minimum at minus 1. Otherwise, at minus 1 is neither minimum, nor maximum. Because if you take this piece, it is minimum. If you take this piece, it is maximum, because in the neighborhood, that is the highest point. Okay. So a possible value of k, anything less than minus 1 among the options, anything is there. Minus 1 itself is there. Option C is there. Okay. All other values are more than minus 1. They are not okay. No. You have to understand graphically. Yes. Whenever discontinuous functions are there, whether attaining local minimum or local maximum, better you should have idea about the graph. For continuous functions, I should have said derivative is zero, second derivative is positive, and all that. But here, there is no point in the second derivative. Second derivative is also zero everywhere. You are writing something? Okay, basically from 27 onwards, these are all like word problems. Of course, they are very simple question. Where the function will not be given. You have to read the question carefully. You have to make the function and then find minimum or maximum value. Like your questions, what is the maximum value of a cone inscribed in a sphere? What is the maximum value of cylinder inscribed in a cone or in a sphere? In IP, you have that important 7-mark questions also, right? That type of question. So in 27, a triangular park is enclosed on two sides by a fence and the third side by a straight river bank. The two sides having same length. Okay, this is a very easy question. See, this is a river. Okay. You have to construct a kind of a triangular park kind of thing, where this is the park. This length is X. This length is X. This angle you can change whatever you want. This side length you can change whatever you want. But that should be the river bank already. Now, so this is X and this is X. What should be the angle between them, or what is the maximum possible area that I can make? very, very easy. Simply take this angle as theta, and theta is variable. What the area of this triangle? Half AB sine C, half into x into sine theta. X square by 2 sine theta. But sine theta maximum value is 1, so this is less than or equal to x square by 2 into 1. So maximum value is x square by 2. That's it. If two sides of an isosceles triangle are x and x, and angle between them is changing, what is the maximum possible area? It will be x square by 2. That will happen when it is right angle triangle. That's it, very simple. You can also, if you rotate the question, also you can understand. Let us say this base is x. Other side, somebody can take x like this, somebody can take x like this, somebody can take x like this. You can take triangle this much, triangle like this. This is the base. Another side can be this or this or this or this. Which case will get maximum area? Every time your height is less than x, but when height itself is x, will have maximum area, which is a rectangle triangle, half into base into height is x square by 2. Like that also you can see. You don't need to use calculus also heavily. Is it clear, 27? Don't waste time. I'm telling you, don't waste time. The minimum area for right angle triangle with hypotenuse h. Okay, there is a right angle triangle, hypotenuse is fixed, this is changing and this is changing. What is the minimum? Yeah, you can take this angle as theta, this will be h cos theta, this will be h sin theta, half into h cos theta into h sin theta. Okay, that is h square by 4 into sin 2 theta. The maximum value is 1. So maximum will be h square by 4. Another way to do same thing is, imagine a circle with diameter h. You take this right angle triangle or this right angle triangle or this or this or this or this. All are right angle triangles in a semicircle. And all of them have hypotenuse h. Which will have maximum area? Whichever has the more height. And if diameter is h, height will be h by 2. And what is the area of this triangle which is having maximum area? Half into h by 2, which is h square by 4. So you can do like this, or you can do like this also, using trigonometry. Of course, if somebody wants, they can also take it as h here, x here, square root of h square minus x, and then say area is equal to half into x into root over h square minus x square. Take that inside, you will get root over h square x square minus x power 4. You can find derivative of this, equal to 0, will get x value. Put that x value back, also will get maximum area. But it is unnecessary, you can do more easily. But if somebody wants to do like this, h square into x square derivative is 2x, and x power 4 derivative is 4x cube equal to 0. You can cancel 1x and 1, 2. We'll get x square equal to h square by 2. Substitute x square as h square by 2 here back. Then you will get maximum area equal to half into root over h square into h square by 2 minus h power 4 by 4. That itself is h power 4 by 4, which is h square by 2. Finally, you are getting h square by 2. You can do any one of the three methods like this, like this, like this. The question is, among all the right angle triangles of hypotenuse H, what is the maximum area? Anybody attempted any NTA Abhyas paper at least one paper in the last 5 days? Attempted. Okay. Anybody else? Which number you attempted? 77. Normally, if somebody is writing an exam where the sample papers are only 2-3 are available, let us say, okay, then they'll be quite scared about the exam because they don't know what kind of questions are going to come. For example, if you see that whenever JEE Advanced IIT JEE exam started, I'm sure the fourth year, very first year, they don't even know what is the question paper anyway. But after 4 years or 5 years still, they hardly have only previous year's papers, 4 papers. Okay, and there are so many concepts that are not even covered in those 4 papers, right? They can give anything. But whereas for you, whether you will do it or not, up to you, but already we have past year mains starting from 2002 to till now. There are around 71 papers. From 2002 to till now, all the JEE mains papers, including online, offline, 71 papers. NTA Abhyas has how many? 109 or increased? 109. So 109 plus 71. You have 180 papers, okay? So you don't have any doubt how the paper will be, what kind of concepts are coming. Only numbers may change for some questions. Otherwise, at least out of 25 questions or 30 questions, you can say 25 questions will be quite similar to one of these questions. Okay, maybe same or few numbers changed and all that. So it's only a matter of your practice and the speed and accuracy. Okay, 33. A wire of length 2 units is cut into 2 parts. I guess this is your standard IP question. You have this IP 7 mark question. Okay. Given in 2016 in JEE mains. Quiet. So you are taking a wire of length 2 units, cutting into 2 parts. One of them you are making in the form of square. One of them you are making in the form of a circle. If the sum of the areas of the square and the circle are so formed is minimum, what is the relation between x and r? So this side length is x, this radius is r. they wanted relation between x and r. Okay. Now, if this side is x, so this length should be 4x. If this is r, this will be 2 pi r. 4x plus 2 pi r is equal to 2. If you want areas, this area is x square, that area is pi r square. I don't want two variables, I want only one variable. So either I have to convert x into r into x. Let's say I choose to convert x into radius. That will be 2 minus 2 pi r by 4. 2 minus 2 pi r by 4 whole square plus pi r square. Of course, I can cancel 2. 1 minus pi r by 2 whole square plus pi r square. Okay, so find dA by dr. dA by dr equal to 0. Derivative of this is 2 into 1 minus pi r by 2 into derivative, the inner part is minus pi by 2 plus pi into 2r. I equate this to 0. Okay, now I have to find r from this. So 1, 2 I can cancel. Another 2 I can send here. Minus pi plus pi r square plus 4 pi r equal to 0. Pi r square, no. Pi square r. So pi also will cancel. I can cancel pi also. So send 2 here and remove pi. I'll get minus 1 plus pi r plus 4 r equal to 0. So I'm getting r equal to 1 by 4 plus pi. The corresponding x I have to find, and then find basically x by r. Okay, let us see what is x by r. X is 1 by 4 plus pi. And I substitute x as 1 by 4 plus pi and simplify it here. R is 1 by 4 plus pi, I can substitute here. That will become 4, 2 by 2 plus pi. R is coming 2 by 2 plus pi. This is is it correct? 1 by 2 by 4 plus pi. I'll substitute 1 by 4 pi plus 4 here. LCM 4 to 2 by 4 plus. Yes, correct. 4 plus pi will cancel. I'll get 1 by 2. That is 2x is equal to r. Is it correct or wrong? Yeah. When I divide with 2 here, I'll get 2x plus pi r equal to 1. I can even do by inequalities, I guess. Let's see if I can do it. It's okay. Don't waste time. They gave option A, x equal to 2r. We got x equal to 2r. I wrote r and x reverse, okay. X correct only. R is 1 by 4 plus pi. This is 2. So this is 2 by 1. So x is equal to 2r. Don't waste time. Okay. 36. They want maximum volume of a right circular cone having slant height is 3. Okay. So there is a cone. This height is 3, slant height. What is the maximum possible volume? You know, like umbrella. If I take an umbrella, keep on opening it. Does the length of the slant height changes for the cone? No, because that is the length of the scope. Okay. So how much are you open? The slant height is same, but the area changes. Base length changes, height changes, so it changes. Okay. I am going to take height as x, and this will be root 9 minus x square. Simply find volume. 1/3 pi r square h. Purposely I chose height as x and wrote radius in terms of. If radius comes square root, I don't mind because I have r square. Root will go anyway. Whereas if I had taken this as x and this as root minus x square, I would have got 1/3 pi x square root 9 minus x square. Differentiation will be little bit tired to do some work. But now it is more easy. 1/3 pi, radius square is 9 minus x square and height is x. It is a very simple cubic expression. As x changes, what is the minimum? Find every derivative of this. dv by dx will come 5/3 into 9 minus 3x square. If you equate it to 0, you'll get x equal to root 3. And they wanted, what is that volume itself, I guess. Put that root 3 back here. So volume maximum 5/3 into, this is 9 root 3, this is 3 root 3, that is 6 root 3, 2 pi root 3. Root 3 pi. Yeah, this kind of questions you have done in first year intermediate for board exam, especially for 7 marks questions are there. But Be serious, don't waste time. Okay, everybody completed 36? Okay, 39. Okay, 39 they gave e power 2i is equal to 1 plus 4x square. They gave a curve, they are asking the range of the magnitude of the slope. We have to find slope of tangent that is varying, mod of that lies between what and what. Okay. I can take like this or I can apply log 2y is equal to log of 1 plus 4x square. Okay. Now let us find slope of tangent. M is dy by dx. These two will become 1 by 2. Log 1 plus 4x square derivative is 1 by 1 plus 4x square into derivative of this is 4 into 2x. Okay, finally it is 4x by 1 plus 4x square. Okay. Mod of this, mod m, you can write 4 into mod x by 1 plus 4x square. They wanted the range, whether less than 1, greater than 1 and all that. Okay. So I can take this itself as f of x, find derivative and do that. Or I can do inequalities. How? Divide with 2 mod x down. You'll get 2 by even this x square. If I choose to write, I can write mod x whole square. I will get 1 by 2 mod x plus mod x, 2 mod x. Even this 2, I can bring it here. 1 by, it neatly looks like arithmetic mean, a plus b by 2. You know a plus b by 2 is greater than or equal to root ab. Okay, so 2 mod x plus 1 by 2 mod x by 2 is greater than or equal to square root of 2 mod x into 1 by 2 mod x. They'll cancel. So this is greater than or equal to 1 means the reciprocal of that is less than or equal to 1. Root of this will this, so that will be less than or equal to 1. Almost same, somebody wants, you can do like this, 2 into 2x by 1 plus 2x whole square. I'll take 2x as tan theta, it will be 2 tan theta by 1 plus tan square theta, which is sine 2 theta. What is the maximum value of sine 2 theta? 1. Again, you can say mod of this will be less than or equal to 1. Or I can even write 2x minus 1 whole square is greater than or equal to 0. Expand this, will get 4x square plus 1 and minus 4x that side. Divide with this, you will get 4x by 4x square plus 1 is less than or equal to 1. Okay. Simply take a suitable perfect square, also you can get. Anyway, you can tell this is less than or equal to 1. So mod m is less than or equal to 1. All right. Okay, they gave f is from closed interval minus 1 to 2 to all real numbers, and f of x is equal to x power 4 plus 3x square plus 1 by x square plus 1. They wanted within this what is the range of this so that you can find a maximum value. Okay, basically absolute maximum. Absolute maximum, especially in a closed interval, it can happen here or in between where derivative is zero. You take a function, let us say varying like this. Okay. So let us just take him from here to here. The maximum value can happen at this end point, or it can happen in the here. The minimum value can happen here or here or here. Okay. For example, I can bring it little down and cut it here, then maximum is here. If I take up to here, maximum is here. Or I can take up to here, maximum can be here. Okay, so maximum can happen at the beginning of the interval, end of the interval, in between, wherever derivative is zero. They are all called critical points. So I don't need the graph and all now. Simply I have to find the value of this function here and find derivative and equal to zero, get some x values, and there among them whichever is the greatest, that is the maximum, whichever is the minimum, that is the absolute minimum. That is one way to do it. Otherwise, I have to think of some, and some questions we are doing a specific method. The general method is using calculus. Okay. I want to take x square plus 1 as t. X square equal to t minus 1. Let us simplify this. This is t minus 1 whole square, 3 into t minus 1 plus 1 by t. And expand, I'll get t square minus 2t plus 3t is plus t. Plus 1, plus 1, plus 2, minus 3 is minus 1 by t. If I open this, I'll get t minus 1 by t plus 1. And my t is greater than or equal to 1. Okay, did I get any benefit after doing this between minus 1 to 2? Okay, what if I directly differentiate, what will come? Let me see that. F dash x. X square plus 1 into the derivative of this is 4x cube plus 6x. And x power 4 plus 3x square plus 1 into the derivative of this is 2x. By x square plus 1 whole square. I can take 2x common here, 2x common here. So 2x will come common. I'll get x square plus 1 into 2x square plus 3. Minus x power 4 plus 3x square plus 1. What kind of people I'm teaching? I don't know. Somebody is not listening to the class. They're doing whatever they want. Somebody is doing some different question. Somebody is talking. So many benches are free, but people want to sit in back benches only. Some people. If this is the kind of sincerity, what are you going to get?
First of all, you have to do most of the questions on your own. I only have to discuss doubts at this stage. Even when discussing, all the people are not listening, and I don't know what are they trying on their own. You cannot even take responsibility for your own studies. In the future, how can somebody trust you with any work? Okay, when I expand this, I'll get 2x power 4. This is 2x square, this is 3x square, this is 5x square. Plus 3 minus x power 4 minus 3x square minus 1. Or x square plus 1 whole square. So 2x into, I'm getting x power 4 plus 2x square plus 2 by x square plus 1 whole square. 2x into, that's a perfect square plus 1, x square plus 1 whole square plus 1. It cannot have any roots. In fact, this is positive, this is positive, this is positive. Sum of three positive numbers can't be 0. It doesn't have any roots. It's always positive. This is also always positive. Everything depends on this. So at 0, derivative is 0. In fact, up to 0, it is decreasing, and after 0, it is increasing, because the derivative sign, negative here, positive here. Okay. So it's some kind of function decreasing and then increasing. So definitely minimum will happen at 0. Maximum may happen at minus 1 or at minus 2, depends on. At 0, when I find the value is 1. At minus 1, when I substitute minus 1 or plus 1, doesn't matter, it will be 5 by 2. Okay. At minus 1, the value is 5 by 2. At 2, what is the value? 16 plus 12, 28, 29 by 5. Okay, this is the graph of the function between minus 1 and 2. So it is an even function. Whatever is there on the right side, left side, same function. And decreasing here and increasing here. From the graph, I can tell this is an absolute minimum. Absolute maximum is this, not this, because that is bigger than this. That's it. What is it they want now? The maximum possible value is happening at 2, which is 29 by 5. Right in the beginning, all I said, when you want to find absolute maximum value in a closed interval, find at the beginning of, you don't need a graph, find the beginning of the interval, end of the interval, and wherever derivative is 0, the critical point. In fact, earlier I erased this. I got t minus 1 by t plus 1. That is t plus minus 1 by t plus 1. And my t is x square plus 1, which is greater than or equal to 1. So t is changing from 1, 2, 3, and maximum, of course. Within this limitation, t has a limitation of up to 5. Okay. So when I took this as t, I clearly know my t value changing from 1 to 5. I know between 1 to 5, this is an increasing function. Why? When t is increasing 1 to 5, this is increasing. 1 by t is decreasing, but with a minus, it is increasing. This is increasing, so that sum will be increasing function. Between 1 to 5, it increases. Where it will have maximum value at 5 only? Substitute 5. 5 minus 1 by 5 plus 1. 5 minus 1 by 5 is 24 by 5 plus 1, which is 29 by 5. Okay. I erased this earlier. I wrote it. I erased it, but I would have told that also. When you take t as x square plus 1, the whole question becomes this much. And t belongs to this. And between 1 to 5, this increasing. So the sum is also increasing. So maximum value is x. You can do like that also. All right. Okay, 45. The real number k for which has two distinct roots between 0 to 1 is actually not possible. 2x cube plus 3x plus k equal to 0. Okay, they want that in between 0 to 1, they should have two distinct roots. It is not possible. You know why? What is the derivative of this? 6x square plus 3, which is always positive. If something is always positive, it is a strictly increasing function. It cross x-axis once. What is pick up between 0 to 1? You take all real numbers also, this equation can have only one root. It will have only one root. If that is between 0 to 1, it will have between 0 to 1, one root. But two roots are not possible. Another way of saying same thing is, we can use the Rolle's theorem to prove the other way. What is that? Let us say this is f of x. And there are two roots between alpha and between 0 to 1, there are two roots. That means f of alpha is also 0, f of beta is also 0. Then according to Rolle's theorem, between alpha and beta, f dash x equal to 0 should have a solution. But f dash x is never 0. That means our assumption that it has two roots between alpha, between 0 to 1 is wrong. Okay. So that's because nowhere derivative is 0, it's not possible to have two roots. Because if there are two roots, in between the roots, the derivative has to be 0 at one point. That is Rolle's theorem. Or you can say directly it is strictly increasing function. It can cross x-axis only once. That too, whether it is between 0 to 1 or not, not sure. But between 0 to 1, two roots it cannot have. A strictly increasing function cannot intersect x-axis twice. Either way, you can say the same. So not, I did not write, I explained. So it's up to you what you want to write. So whatever k you take, whether you take k 100,000 or something, doesn't matter. It is not possible to find a k. So that this equation has two roots between 0 to 1. So anybody, any backlogs in application of derivatives, please complete by tomorrow everything. We'll discuss doubts tomorrow. Thank you.